The story of this place, this sanctuary, lies hidden by time. It's a story of change revealed by context and perspective. A story born of water and dreams. A story that's played out over millennia and a single breath. Monterey Bay we know today is only a brief moment in that story. The rest of it goes something like this. About 4.5 billion years after the Earth formed, people first settled along the edge of what is now an underwater canyon. That was only about 10 to 12,000 years ago. For most of that time, we maintained a fairly good balance with nature. But inevitably, more people came and big changes quickly followed. Though this place hardly resembles what it once was, there are plenty of wild spaces left to explore. This place was just a stop along the way for me. Monterey is part of a circuit I make each year to train people not to do what millions of years of evolution has made our greatest imperative, to breathe. Breathing, time passes without notice. But hold your breath, and every heartbeat, every thought, every action becomes more relevant. Maybe that's because every freedive has an endpoint that is affected by what you do in the moment. Every decision determines when and how the dive will end. Not much different than other choices we make in life, just more immediate. But we're not the only freedivers in the bay, and definitely not the best. The best breath hold divers in the bay are usually seen on the beach. Today, it's hard to imagine that in the 1800s, after falling easy prey to hunters, northern elephant seals were thought to be extinct. After weaning their pups, exhausted females run a gauntlet of males to get back to the sea for their first meal in over a month. Elephant seals can dive over 5,000 feet, deep enough to reach the cold, dark waters of Monterey Canyon, where an upwelling of nutrients rise from the heart of the bay to feed one of the richest, most diverse ecosystems on the planet. If the canyon is the heart of the bay, the life that gathers here is its soul. People travel from around the world to watch wildlife here. Of all the creatures in the bay, perhaps none is more adored than the sea otter. Otters spend a lot of time grooming coats that allow them to survive in cold water. That dense fur was their undoing in the 1800s, when otters were voraciously hunted for their valuable pelts. By the late 19th century, like elephant seals before them, they were wiped out. Kelp beds, once teeming with otters, were now missing a key part of their ecosystem. Kelp forests play a critical role in supporting life not only along the coast, but the entire bay. While otters were disappearing along the coast, offshore, whales were the focus of exploitation. When early explorers arrived in Monterey, there were so many whales that people on shore complained about the stench of their breath. It didn't take long before whales, too, became a rare sight. There's one constant in this place. It's the waves that have sculpted the shoreline for millions of years. No longer preyed upon by otters, the exploding abalone population created yet another irresistible business opportunity. With few restrictions, the fishery rapidly consumed itself, and within a few decades, abalone were no longer commercially viable. A About the same time the abalone fishery was beginning to wane, canneries were busy processing the next big catch, sardines. By the early 50s, the sardine fishery had also collapsed, bringing to an end an era of unbridled exploitation. Compared to our lifetime, we have been here for a mere breath in the history of the bay. Even before the sardine fishery reached its end, many thought the changes we had made left little hope for the future. But something amazing happened. Otters were rediscovered along the Big Sur coast. Soon, they were put under federal protection, and their numbers grew. Over the years, elephant seals, also thought to be extinct, returned to their rookeries. And large numbers of whales could once again be seen offshore. Eventually, a grassroots effort was started in Santa Cruz, which led to the creation of the Monterey Bay National Marine Sanctuary in 1992. And with it came all the challenges of balancing protection with use. Managing marine ecosystems is tricky business, especially at a time when needs and climate are constantly changing. Everything we put on land eventually makes its way into the sea, and our demands are increasing at a dizzying rate. Like other animals, it is our nature to take what we can when the opportunity presents itself. If we learn from the past, we can use our experience to temper our nature and create places where wildlife and humans can coexist. When I first came to this place, I had a picture in my mind of what a national marine sanctuary was. But I've learned that what any sanctuary becomes is up to us. Sanctuaries, it turns out, are what we make them. The context in which we view time sharpens our perspective. And with this vision, this knowledge, comes power. The power to destroy and the power to heal. In a mere breath in the history of this place, we have done both. In the next breath, there is no limit to what we can achieve.
Sun shines brightly down on Penny's place.
The sun shines brightly down on the bay.
The air's so clean that it takes your mind away. Cascades of the cool, clear water, and the sun dance final scene sets the hills of
the sunshine sets the hills all ablaze.
Horizon edges quick up the mountains way.
Hey.